Hello everyone, this is Take from bigheadtaco.com and welcome to my home studio. I'm here, I don't think I've ever shot in this room before. This is actually my corner of mine and Camera Girl's home studio, home office. Most of it is hers, most of the space is hers, and that's why I've rarely shot in here. But I was just working on my review of the brand new XF16mm f2.8 RWR and wanted to look at its vlogging video abilities. I just want to see how it renders for video. And then when I looked at how it looked like, it looked beautiful. This is going to be an awesome video lens. And right now I have this on my Tsurui tabletop tripod, and it's about an arm length. Like, I can just touch the front of this lens here, so it's about, you know, 2.5 feet from me right now. And for vlogging, I'd probably be about this close, because right now I'm holding on. Here we go. So you can see that I'm holding on to the tripod. So this is about full arm lengths out. I like to be about this close, which might feel a little bit too close for you guys. You know, sometimes when you're in a restaurant, you want to be kind of like this, and maybe not whisper, but talk quietly, or else people think you're insane. But in this office space, I could be about this far off and it is fine. And the microphone, the Rode VideoMicro, is picking up my voice really good. But I'm pretty impressed because, you know, the 16-1-4 probably can't focus this fast. So we'll just put this up here like this. We'll see how that focuses on here, and then back onto my face, and then back. You know, even grab something else. How about this? Something is not that it won't fully encompass the screen, and will it focus on that right there? It's a tax, kind of a it's a lens inspired watch, and then back onto me, and then back onto here. And so the beauty of this 16-28 lens is that it has that, like all the other Fujicrons, it has a quick, quiet, and accurate focusing system. Now, this camera lens will probably be more accurate on something like an X-T30. I'm shooting this on an X-H1, and the reason for that is because this lens does not have stabilization, the IBIS on the X-H1 will take care of that. And so I'm gonna be testing that in the park behind my house, and then I'm gonna head over to the studio and probably look over the footage and then give you my quick conclusion of what I think about this lens for video. But so far, I'm pretty darn impressed. And so let's head out to the back and then off to my studio to conclude this video. Boom! All right, guys, as promised, I'm in the park just in behind my house, and I have with me the Fujifilm X-H1 with the 16 f2.8 RWR and a Rode VideoMicro. I did increase the frames per second. When I was in my studio, it was at 24 frames per second, so that means my shutter speed was 1/48th of a second. And now I have moved up to 60 frames per second because of how bright the light is. I am at auto ISO, but I found that even when I set my aperture, it still seemed like it was a bit too bright, so I put it to auto aperture as well as auto ISO. So you might see a little bit of stepping in when the camera decides to change the aperture. With a neutral density filter, especially when you have one that's variable, you could probably control that. I'm not a very complicated videographer. I usually just have one with me if I'm doing something complicated. But here, as the sun hits my face, you could probably see how the camera is now gonna try to auto adjust for the exposure. And you might see a little bit of stepping in terms of, you can see when it's either, it's probably the ISO that's jumping that you're seeing. But when I have it to aperture, I choose the aperture and I just stick there, I don't see that stepping. I didn't even see that with the XE3 that easily. So that, it must be that, it must be the auto aperture that's causing that. But anyways, the big thing is using this lens, the 16 f2.8 with the X-H1, because X-H1 does have in-body image stabilization. And I think that's probably the best combination. Like what I saw in my studio, and I really enjoyed sort of the rendering. I have this on Pro Neg Standard, and I like that because it's kind of, Eterna is a little bit too flat profile for me. So I do have Pro Neg Standard and I have -1 shadow detail. And to me, that looks great for video. I find the classic chrome, it crushes the shadows a little bit too much. And so, yeah, so
I don't really know what I got, if this looks good or not, but it feels like it's doing a good job. The X-H1 is a bigger, heavy body, but then to compensate, I have the 16F2.8. So I'm actually gonna, when I get back, I'm gonna do the math of XT30 with the 10-24, the weight of it, and then the X-H1 with the 16-28, and see which kit is bigger or heavier. But for now, I'm actually pretty impressed just with the size of the 16-28. It's so compact and small that it feels less obtrusive when I'm out and about shooting. So let's now head back to the studio and I'll give you my final thoughts of this combination for video as well as for vlogging. All right. I thought I would do a test inside my car as well, just to show you. I'm in the back seat of my car. My arm is fully extended out. I couldn't, when I was sitting in the driver's seat, it was like this close, and it felt a little too close, a little too loud. And I just wanted to show you what it would look like. I'm at f2.8 right now, and I was so when I was at my home studio, I left it at f2.8 to purposely get that shallow depth of field, so you couldn't see the mess in the background. It wasn't that messy. Sorry, camera girl. But I just wanted to blur out the background, and I'm doing the same thing here in my car, so this is what it looks like. All right, in my studio. Sorry for the mess. Every time I come in here, I feel like Mr. Rogers. Every time I come into my studio, I hang my outside jacket. I have my studio shoes that I wear. These shoes are from a brand called Peoples. Shout out to Peoples. And then I wear these are like my, I'm not gonna show you a sequence of me putting my shoes on, but you know, Mr. Rogers, when he comes in, he takes off his jacket and he puts on a sweater. So I do have studio clothes. And so I'm gonna finish my first thoughts on this lens for video very shortly. So just give me a second. All right, so now I'm using a mirror as, a way to show kind of my setup here. You can see the X-H1 with a 16F2.8 RWR Rode VideoMicro and a Tsurui tabletop tripod. And seeing that tally light helps me know that the camera's still recording, that it didn't die, the card didn't run out, the battery didn't die, anything like that. And I find that more effective than having a monitor, because, I mean, a monitor could also have a sort of a blinking red light to let you know that it's recording, but I find it's a distraction unless you're putting, like, I don't know where I put it, but sunglasses. So, like what Casey Neistat does, so it doesn't look like he's looking at it. Anyways, my thoughts so far is pretty darn good. Now, this mirror shot is not an indicator of distortion, because you're assuming that this mirror is distortion free. It's probably a little bit of distortion on it, but I'm doing this angle just so you can see my setup here holding this in my hand. Might have to back up a little bit more so you can see the whole thing. And let's do a conclusion of what my thoughts are on using this combination for vlogging. All right, so that's my first thoughts on the Fujifilm XF16mm F2.8 RWR lens for vlogging. And right now this is a talking headpiece. I would not recommend this lens for talking headpiece. I find that the XF23 F2 RWR is perfect for that, and that's what I use in my studio. Now that lens, when I'm talking, is about a meter or so away. I'm about half a meter away. So about, you know, like I could touch the lens. I can touch the camera. This is about vlogging distance. And so unless you are cramped for space, so let's say you're in a really narrow apartment, which is not unusual in places like Hong Kong and Tokyo, then maybe this would work. But autofocus is pretty good, as you can see. I still have it on the X-H1, on the, I should have turned IBIS off. I didn't. And that's typically, if you have it on a tripod, remove IBIS, because sometimes it could actually try to correct for something that's not there. But as a vlogging lens, I think it's a pretty darn good option. And I did actually write down the numbers here, the X-H1 with the XF16-28 and the weight of it, the final weight, versus the XT30 with the 10-24. And the reason why I compared these two is because I picked the lightest body with the best autofocus with a stabilized lens. The 10-24 does have OIS, versus the X-H1, because it is stabilized through IBIS,
the in-body stabilization, then you can pretty much put any lens on there. And I think the 16-28 is a really good lens for it to be stabilized. It keeps it reasonably light, but you can top with the weight there. It's 30 plus grams difference in weight between the two kits, so it's not a huge difference. So if you want to use the X-H1 with the 16-28 for vlogging, it'll work out. But if you want the X-T30 for vlogging, then you can't use this lens unless you're using an external, like a 3-axis gimbal, which adds even more weight. And currently what I'm using is this modified Tsurui tabletop tripod here. You can just put the legs down, lock it, and now it's a tabletop. It goes up one level like this. And I modified it because I don't like the quick release plates. I like just to be able to screw this on and off. And so this is an old Cullman tripod that I removed and put on here. And then the legs go up, and now this is a vlogging sort of a stick. And then it has a little thing on the bottom, a ring, so you can just attach this onto your camera bag or just clip it onto your belt or whatever it is. So I'm gonna be using this because I'm pretty pleased with it. I'm gonna be using this on an upcoming trip to test for vlogging. And well, I mean, I just tested it now. I'm pretty impressed with it. It's still a little bit like, if I was in a restaurant, I'd want to be probably about this close. And you know, I'm dropping my voice now because the Rode VideoMicro can pick up my voice pretty good. But in general, I would wish it was 14, but the XF14 f2.8 is just, the focus is noisy, slow, and inaccurate, like a lot of the first generation XF lenses. Great for the time, but compared to the new Fujicrons, it doesn't compare. You can even tell right now how quiet the focus is on this right now. And I'm at f2.8 to try to blur the background as best as possible so you can really see if the lens is hunting a lot. And I do have this on area, not multi-area, but area focus and on center. So I want to make sure I'm centered in general. So again, this is the sort of the weight difference between the two kits. So you decide which way you want to go. You saw me with the 10 to 20, four on the X-T30 already, and now this is the 16-28 on the X-H1. One thing is you can't zoom in and out, which is sometimes pretty good when you're vlogging, be able to just zoom in on something as you turn the camera around and then zoom back out and shoot. You can't do that with this, but it does keep your kit nice and tight and small and compact. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and happy shooting.